Jai Shri Krishna, Jai Shri Ramachandra, Jai Shri Lakshmi Krishna. Today I'm going to talk about the very atrocious state of our country, wherein we are allowing the production, the sales, etc. of liquor and alcohol products, whereas we are closing and slowly barring down the entry into any temple. Temples are the abode of goodness, are the abode of morality. They are basically the abodes of all divine qualities that are present within a human. We go to temples to remind ourselves of God every single moment because we are part and parcel of God. That is the basic necessity of a temple construction in a city. That's why every city in our Vedic times used to have a temple. Every village used to have a temple, at least. In fact, in the past, each city used to have more than 100 temples. Even now, these temples are continuing, but slowly in this lockdown time, the government is barring all temples, but at the same time, the irony is that they are allowing the sales of liquor products, showing that people are dying without the presence of such alcoholic beverages, which are extremely horrible for humanity, which can cause severe issues in family, severe issues in the society, and can cause damage to various people, and even now has actually caused so many accidents and troubles, even more than the death toll of the COVID-19. It has killed more people than COVID-19. Why should it be allowed during this period, especially during this period? This is a time when people who drink liquor should basically de-addict themselves from drinking liquor. It's not the time when people are allowed to have liquor. People should start de-addicting themselves. Those who are drinking liquor, this is a wonderful advantage for you all. And it's a wonderful time for you to start de-addicting yourself from the alcoholic addiction. This way you can consume ajwain or trachyspermum ammi. It's called ajovan. You can search for it. And you can also consume this along with water and other things like that. Drink a lot of water in a day and consume food in a good quantity, in a limited quantity, etc. So many more things that can be done to de-addict yourself from liquor. And this lockdown time can be a wonderful time to stop yourself from drinking liquor. But this is only possible. Liquor addicts and alcohol addicts can only adhere to such things when the government is also favorable to the de-addiction of their present addiction. So the government should cooperate, should close completely, at least during this lockdown time and even after the lockdown time, all the sales of liquor. Instead, what they're doing is they are closing temples and they're slowly limiting essential commodities also. Even if they don't limit essential commodities, they are closing temples completely, closing the doors of gods, of the deities inside, present inside in the statue form, which are constantly giving us vibrations, wonderful, beautiful vibrations. I shall explain why a temple is important later in this video, but before this I would like to tackle the topic of liquor and wine drinking and alcohol consumption. We are printing notes of Gandhiji on our currency. We are spending 150 crores of taxpayers' money every year for Gandhi Jayanti. And yet, we are not understanding what he said. He said, liquor is the wine, liquor or alcohol is the cause of all miseries in gist. He said this, and still we are not following him at all. And the government, which seems to be following him, is continuing the production, the sales of this liquor, of this wine. It should be immediately stopped. If this is not stopped, the world will continue to suffer due to its karmas. Especially the governments will suffer a lot due to their karmas. There will be a lot of issues. You can watch my video on the future of the world from 2020 to 21 and how we can stop the next issues that may come up at the end of this year and the beginning of the next year. You can watch all these things and understand the current situation of the world and just imagine what may happen next if we don't stop our karmas. Now, right now, we have to stop the karmas of killing animals, stop the karmas of liquor, etc. Why will butcher stalls and non-vegetarian hotels, etc. open even after the lockdown, which is severe violence to animals and that comes back to us, though in a limited quantity? We should be thankful to God for that. God has limited our sufferings, even though we are causing more suffering to the animals. We should be thankful to God for that. But now it's a bigger atrocity. We are closing all shrines of gods, including mosques and churches also. Apart from temples, I would also like to talk about the mosques and churches which are being closed. They can be closed to the people, but at least their doors should remain open, my dear friends. Why I say this is, God is the starting point of everyone's life. God is the creator, and God, who can be called in various names and various words and can be given various ways to praise, but He is the beginning of all creation, the beginning of all life. We must remember Him at every single stage. And that's why a temple was there in the past. And the temple, which is consecrated with a lot of religious observances, is an extremely powerful tool to relieve humans of their sufferings by remembering Him always, and to promise in front of the idol that we shall not do any more distress to the earth, to the animals and other creations of God, and not even to our fellow human beings. That's why a temple is present, to remind us of our work, to remind us of God. So therefore it should remain open, and at least people should be allowed inside in a limited quantity based on the space that is present in the temple. Certain temples are 1 acre, 2 acres and 3 acres. So based on that, the number of people allowed inside and the distancing can be maintained, and quite a number of people can be allowed inside in such huge temples. It's not correct to close all temples. This is only going to cause more issues. The doors of the temple should remain open. God should, so the image of the Lord should be open to the people to be able to see Him, because we as humans can only turn to one supreme being, that is God, no one else. So if that is closed, those who are aware of God from within, they can pray to God at any place on earth. They can pray to God even in the worst of places on earth. But the common men and the normal people, and even the highly elevated people, whoever they are, even if they are rishis or great people too, the beautiful image of Lord that is consecrated inside the temple just gives us the physical remembrance of His personality. Therefore, we can always remember Him, and therefore temples shouldn't be closed. But alcohol and such horrible things have to be closed. Otherwise, there are various political people who are coming up with new theories that people are dying due to alcohol, the non-availability of alcohol. But I would like to tell you one thing, my dear friends, that the availability of alcohol is far more dangerous than the non-availability of alcohol. The number of deaths in our human history are more than even COVID-19. The ones I'm talking about are due to intoxication. They are even more than COVID-19. If we just look at how many people have died till date, and how many families and societies have been ruined due to intoxication, COVID-19 deaths are just nowhere even close to this. Addiction is even more powerful than contagious infections. It can be proven by all science. So it should be completely stopped. If the government is interested in revenue, is interested in the money, etc., that comes from such evil activities, they have to immediately stop it, because this is not the sign of a good government. A citizen looks up to the government as a parent, and the parent should be doing something good for the people, not something bad. So my dear friends, here it is. The government has to stop it. And has to allow the limited opening of temples at least after the lockdown, should immediately stop all production and even sales of liquor. And people who are addicted to liquor need to transform themselves and not look at the transformation of the government for their benefit. And in fact, this whole lockdown is towards the benefit of everyone. Just imagine how much more time we get to do things that are very important and we were not doing before. How much more time liquor addicts get to de-addict themselves. How much more time people get to spend with their own families. And my dear friends, please stop looking at your smartphones all the time in this lockdown event. You can start having time with family. You can start discussing various things. You can start transforming society in a little way at your own home, and even in a bigger way later on. You can do so many more things instead of glaring at those flickering screens of the mobiles. Children can study wonderful subjects and come out of this blocked school approach that they're having. And my mother is also coming out with a video on how to homeschool in the coming week. And you can watch my video on the future of the world 2020-21 for more information on what's going to happen and how we can stop it. And the link is given over here. So thank you. Jai Shri Ramachandra. Jai Shri Krishna. Jai Shri Lakshmi Narayana.